So I would like now to give the floor to Jan Terlouw for the final reflection about the topic of human rights of future generations. Jan Terlouw is a former politician and a well-known writer in the Netherlands. So thank you very much.
Good day, ladies and gentlemen. 11 years of my life, I have spoken more English than Dutch, but that is 30 years ago, so I may be looking for words. I have 16 great-grandchildren, and when I look at these lovely little creatures, I often think, they have absolutely no tools to make us act responsibly. I have heard today again how many aspects are connected with what we are talking about, how to become good ancestors. It is very complex. For instance, what Stientje said indirectly is that if we do not change the economic system, an economic system where the key words are profit and growth, then we shall never solve it. In the last 500 million years, five times the world, the living world, has been almost extinct. Up to 80% of the living plants and animals disappeared. And all five times, the causes were not natural. They were not natural causes. It was a meteorite that fell on Texas. It was emission of phosphor from volcanoes and so forth. And now, for the sixth time, the extinction is a threat. The reason is natural. Namely, one living creature is causing it. A creature that belongs to nature, mankind. And what we're doing is so complex because there's so much short-term interest involved. And it is so difficult to go and act to long-term differences and think of those who are not yet born and are dependent on us. What can we do? What can we do? Maybe one thing is important, to give rights to rivers and rights to forests, so that if their interests are threatened by us, the living people, that judges can protect them with the help of these rights. I've written a novel, the name in Dutch is Het Hebzuchtgas, where in that novel young people achieve that managers, industrialists, when they have a meeting, there always is an empty chair, the future chair, in their midst. And in that chair sitting the future. They talk with them. They must not forget that they are always important. What does it mean for the future what we are doing? I think it's also important that if politicians have to make a decision with long-term effects, that it is compulsory that a study is made what are these long-term effects, and that for those who have to make the decision, that they have to see this and take it into account. That may also be very important to do. Mr. Roman Kay, I can't express his last name. he wrote in his book that hope is more important than optimism. I'm not sure I agree with that. Hope makes us live, gives a living. But optimism makes us act in a positive way, I think. You have to be optimistic to have the courage to do something, to act. We have just had the Glasgow meeting, and you may be disappointed about the results. But one thing is good. Everybody is talking about it now. Every reasonable person in this world knows now that what we do is important for the future, is important for those who are not yet born, for the future generations. And also a meeting like today, it makes me optimistic that you come here today together 2 days to think about it, to talk about it, to realize we have to act, we have to do something. And then I'm the optimist to say it can be done. There is no reason why it could not be done. Let's take an example in a forest rainwood, a big oerwoud, a forest rainwood. Every second there are billions of activities in a rainwood like that. Every molecule is sometimes in an animal, sometimes in a plant, sometimes in the earth, sometimes in the air. It's never lost, it's always used. And one thing is necessary, but has to be added, and that's energy. Energy has to come from the outside, and therefore we have the sun. And the human community could, in the same way, exist. Just animal of the sun, and not use the sun, which has in hundreds of millions of years been stored in the earth, and which we burn in a few hundred years. That is 1 million times faster, 100 million times faster than it has been formed. That is irresponsible behavior. But it can be done. There is enough energy every day of the sun. It is enough for all our activities. We can do it. And we shall only do it if we talk about it, if we are aware of what we are doing, if we stimulate each other, inspire each other, and that you are doing so today. And I respect that very much, and I hope we will continue to believe that it can be done, and that we are convinced that it has to be done for those who are unborn, and that we are very unjust if we're not the right ancestors. So thank you very much that I have the opportunity to say these few words, and much success tomorrow. Thank you.
Thank you so much, the Nestor of our society, Jan Terlouw. Beautiful. And let's act on that.